Okay, so I have to figure out how to articulate this, so give me a second. So I just ended up writing for about 40 minutes that wound up going from a series of thoughts to then a series of me researching my thoughts and questions and finding the answers to what does binaural beats do to the human body. A couple of things that I already know so far because science is that sound can manipulate the shape of a snowflake. What does the shape of a snowflake have anything to do with binaural beats and the universe? A snowflake is made out of water, and water is just another form of matter, and then the human body is also made up of 60% water, so that means that sound can manipulate the human body. Yeah. Then I ended up wanting to ask, what does the water in our bodies do as far as functionality goes? With that question being asked, it led me to research, well, what is the functionality of water in our body? I looked up what is the function of water in the human body. Google that. The answer came up as, it allows cells to grow, reproduce, and survive, flushes body waste, mainly in the form of urine because urine is mostly water, lubricates your joints. Water is also a major component of most body parts, helps deliver oxygen to the entire body, that's pretty important. It also converts food to components needed for survival, meaning digestion. So, here's actually something to think about. If food is needed for survival, what if we no longer felt as though we had to survive? The thought of survival is actually the fear of dying, is it not? I mean, that kind of makes sense to me. In order to survive means not to die. So what if there was no fear of death? What if there was no reason to fear death? I mean, who knows? Is death real? That's an interesting thing to think about. If you can even think about it, like, that's just another subject that I don't even know if I can get into. I need to go to college for this. What if the human psyche no longer had fear of death? So then would that mean that we could figure out a way to live an incredibly long time without eating? So that's something to think about. Comment your response on that. Like, what do you think? Is that even a thing? Is that even a theory? Can that happen? Can you live without eating? Can you survive by the air? Like, I have no idea where my mind is going. Another functionality, as the list comes to an end, is that water acts as a shock absorber for the brain and spinal cord, regulates body temperature via sweat and respiration. Yes, not perspiration, respiration. You ever wonder why dogs like breathe really heavy in the summertime? Because they're cooling their bodies down. Needed by the brain to manufacture hormones and neurotransmitters. So, in science class, I know that hormones are actually a really important part of the, you know, the way our human body works. So, it led me to ask, what do hormones do for the human body, you know? I type that in Google. It says, hormones serve as messengers controlling and coordinating activities throughout our bodies. I could have, you know, read this off of screen, but I'm only working with a phone right now, so I don't have a separate camera where I can film and also look at information on my phone because I don't have a camera right now. So knowing that led me to then figure out, well, if our bodies is made up of 60% water and sound can manipulate water, because we've seen it done on snowflakes. You know, you can look up the YouTube videos and see the proof. Then that means that sound can probably also manipulate reality. Externally and internally, because water is all around us and we're made of water too. So this is where binaural beats and knowing what sound can do to water come hand in hand. So it says when I do research on listening to binaural beats, it says that you should listen to frequencies less than 1,000 hertz. So in order for your brain to detect these frequencies, it has to be less than 1,000. I suppose the higher the frequency, the more, I don't know, anxiety it causes or something like that. There are 4 different patterns of binaural beats. They go from delta, theta, alpha, and beta. Delta patterns are responsible for dreamless sleep. Theta is responsible for rapid eye movement in sleep or in REM phase, also within meditation and creativity. Alpha is responsible for the feelings of relaxation, and beta is responsible for concentration and alertness, but also sometimes anxiety, says the higher the frequency in the beta pattern. My phone is dying. So now I have to stand and do the rest of this video. Get some vitamin D. Okay, I have to switch phone positions because my phone is dying. So here's the better bit of this information. So at 396 hertz is ute or ut. I'm not really sure how you pronounce it, but it's responsible for turning grief into joy, liberating guilt and fear, realization, and achieving goals. Ray is at 417 hertz, and it is responsible for undoing situations and facilitating change. Me, which I find most exciting, is at 528 hertz, and that is the me scale. And that is responsible for returning DNA to its original and perfect state, transformations and miracles, or ecstatic states like deep inner peace, dance, and celebration. I hope I really don't start breaking out into dance. That would be hilarious. Fa at 639 hertz, reconnecting and balancing relationships, harmonious community and interpersonal relationships. It's responsible for communication, understanding, comma, tolerance, and love. And, you know, again, communicating with cells, with its environment. It's communicating with its environment. Cells are communicating with the environment. So again, that just kind of means, like, all of this can probably warp reality. Everything in the world is made of cells. Getting close to the end of the list, soul, like S-O-L, and it's at 852 hertz. Solving problems, expressions, and solutions. Cleans the cell from toxins, leads to a healthier and simpler life, and to changes in diet towards foods which are not poisoned. As this being the fifth frequency, it is also explained, it leads you into the power of self-expression, which leads to pure, stable life. Like, I really hope that this is, like, real stuff. Then you can just, like, use sound for everything.
Use sound for everything.
now on the fourth page and final law, which is at 852 hertz. An additional frequency that was discovered by a doctor named Dr. Leonard Horowitz. So he discovered the entire solfeggio frequency scale. 852 hertz is responsible for awakening intuition, returning to spiritual order. What are they implying when it comes to spiritual order? I'm kind of skeptic when it comes to like certain bits of spirituality, but like I feel as though my mind is being opened a little bit more as I get older and as I find more and more things to just basically research for no reason. It is responsible for seeing through illusions of life, such as hidden agendas of people, places, and things, opening up for communication with the all-embracing spirit. I have no idea what this spirit is about, but like, I intend to find out. Lets you return to spiritual order, once again, there's that spiritual order word, regarding to the cellular processes. 852 hertz enables the cell to transform itself into a system of higher level. So you can use this to transform at a higher level, meaning a higher state? I don't know. Almost lastly, the C frequency, or psi frequency, I think it's SI, so I'll just say psi, is at 963 hertz. Now, I've seen this frequency labeled as the miracle frequency. So what it is responsible for is awakening any system to its original perfect state. I think that's miraculous, if it's true. It is connected with the light and all-embracing spirit. What is with this spirit? Like what? The Holy Spirit enables direct experience.
The return to oneness. Like feeling, I suppose, all right with oneself. Is that oneness?
What do you think oneness is? What is oneness to you? I'm not really sure. I don't really understand the feeling of oneness yet. So we'll find out. Again, like, I'm doing this experiment by listening to binaural beats, so, you know, you try it too. See what happens, and like, I don't know, if you experience anything, put it in the comments. 174 hertz is used as a natural anesthetic and pain reducer. And last but not least, 285 hertz, which helps return tissue to its original form. So in 40 minutes, I found all of that stuff out simply by Googling the questions that I ended up asking myself. So in my mind, it's completely blown. Like knowing all this information, just having it written out seems almost ridiculous. It's like, it seems and sounds like it's almost impossible. Like, how can sound do all of that? And if it's true, how can we apply this theory to the world? You know, like, because it sounds like if you do some of these things, you can probably end up making the world a much better place, I think. I definitely feel like my mind was blown after finding this stuff out, and not only just like just reading about it, but like actually listening to some of these beats that are provided on YouTube, and you can listen to them. It's recommended that you listen to that, to the music, with headphones, because each frequency goes into one ear slightly different, so that's how it works. You need headphones. So put on your headphones and listen to these beats And I don't know, me personally, I definitely felt a little strange. Like, I felt something was obviously going on. I can't explain it, but I definitely felt as though there was something happening in my body. Again, you try it, whoever's watching this, and let me know what you felt when you listened to any of these frequencies that I listed. And, you know, I'll leave a link to, you know, the information that you can find about these particular frequencies and what they do and how you can, like, apply it to searching on YouTube so you can listen to it. Alright, so thank you very much for, you know, watching this video, and, you know, please do experiment with this because I think it's really interesting. I think it's really cool. It seems pretty far-fetched, but at the same time, it seems to also make sense. So, yeah, try it out. Experiment. Use headphones, definitely, you know. Do it when you sleep. I think that's the best way to do it, because I feel like this is a great way to try and get into meditating. If you've never meditated before and you have no idea how to, because it gives you, it just puts you in a state almost naturally, you know, while you're going to sleep. Like, I definitely feel a lot better since doing this, and it's kind of weird. So it's very weird to say this, because I never thought that I would be recording something like this and, like, saying things like this, but I firmly believe that there is a science to binaural beats and the effects that it has on not just your body, but quite possibly reality itself. So I'll see you next time in my next video. So yeah, subscribe, like this, pass it around, you know, like, I think people need to know a little bit about this stuff. I'll see ya.